In 1875, the Emperor Tongzhi passed away without any kids. As the normal heirs rule, Tongzhi's heir should be his next generation. But Cixi wanted to keep her political powers, so she pressured Cian to choose the 3-year-old Zai Tian as the new emperor, known as the Emperor Guangxu. The court still was controlled by two emperor's daughters. In 1888, Guangxu was already 70 years old. For Qing empress, it was age that must get married. Although Cixi still wanted to delay Guangxu's marriage, under government officers' pressure, she had to hold the imperial election for Guangxu. Because Cian already passed away in 1881, this time Cixi could arrange Guangxu's marriage all by herself. The empress candidate was Cixi's niece, Ye He Na La. Because Guangxu's biological mother was Cixi's sister, and Ye He Na La's father was Cixi's brother, so Ye He Na La was Guangxu's cousin, and she was 3 years older than Guangxu. In Qing Dynasty, 8 banners girls started to join the imperial election when they were 13 years old. Normally, Ye He Na La should already get married and maybe already become a mother. So it's highly possible that Cixi planned to arrange this marriage for years. According to lots of historical documents, Cixi didn't like this niece at all. Ye He Na La wasn't a pretty woman, or more accurate, she was ugly, even in Qing people's view. Meanwhile, she was a quiet person and didn't have any talents. I think Cixi chose her for 3 reasons. First, learned from Tongzhi's marriage, Cixi didn't want to have a daughter-in-law who wasn't in her team. Second, Cixi wanted to improve her original family's status. Third, Cixi wanted Ye He Na La clan had an empress who came in the Forbidden City through Da Qing Men, Da Qing Gate. I will tell you the story of Da Qing Gate in next video. Although in imperial election, there was a small accident, but this couldn't change the result. Under Cixi's order, Guangxu had to choose Ye He Na La as his empress. The following year, Guangxu's wedding process started. Before the wedding ceremony, Tai He Gate was burned. Because in the wedding ceremony, the empress must go through Tai He Gate, people thought this was a bad signal to the marriage. But Cixi didn't care. She ordered a craftsman to build a new Tai He Gate using paper, so the wedding could be finished on time. On the wedding night, Guangxu was really sad. He cried and told his empress that she was his cousin. He really respected her, but no way could treat her as wife. According to Qing inner court rules, Guangxu and Longyu spent 3 days in Kunning Palace. Then they stayed in their own residential palace. From the point leaving the Kunming Palace, Longyu rarely saw her husband. Guangxu quickly fell in love with his noble concubine, Zhen, who was more famous named the consort Zhen. This time, Cixi did nothing to force Guangxu to visit Longyu. So, Longyu actually became a widow when her husband was still alive. Guangxu and consort Zhen didn't have a happy ending. We will know it in next video. Thank you for watching this video. See you soon.